Yeah, to bring you this far, I now created a new push. Let's check in the repository. If you missed something or there's some code unclear, you need something to know, just go to the github.com Jan Paul Dahlke and then to the React boilerplate. There, please go to the branch of Zookeeper Asynchronous. And here, if you go now to the commits, yeah, you can see this commit, make Ajax with Thunk. You can browse the repository at this point in the history, click here. And if you do so, you can see the complete state of our application at this moment. So if you have any questions or anything is unclear, just visit this commit of the repository. And I think we are pretty much prepared to, let's check our browser here. Let's close some things. I don't think we need them. Yeah, let's even close this. Let's close this one too. So again, what we are doing, we are making use of the static reducer here. The static reducer shows us the properties of our animals. Please, I want you to see that here the name is like, the species is like shark or cat or ape and so on. And I think we are pretty much done for now. What would you think of, what do we need to do to make this thing work in the way we want? To help you a little bit, I would like to console log this props again. So what I will do is I will change to my console. I will log the properties. You can see this is the first render cycle. The animal list is null, but now we have this beautiful, property here on the component. For one, we have this animals here, but this is what we want to get rid of. And here we have this animals list. Nice and easy on the same level of our application. So what prevents us from going to this, here is where we render the complete LI. So let's go to this component and let's contemplate on this component again. What are we doing here? We are returning the result of a map function, and each of these animals inside here will be rendered to complete LI. So what prevents us from, let's say, we have here not only animals, but we also have animal list here. What prevents us from, you know, iterating over the animal list map instead of mapping over animals? So let's give it a try, a very naive try in the browser. I will close the console now. I will reload. And as you can see, wow, it happened. Just by renaming this one property, we are now able to, okay, we have a little bit of a displaying problem because this is on the top of it. You know, if I see here, if I click here, yeah, if I'm out of the view, yeah, I would not be able to see it, what's on there, but this is a CSS problem. It's solvable. There is a solution, or there are several solutions for this, I'm pretty sure. And here we can see are the names of our animals now. So let's check out the localhost 3000 to verify that we're fetching this correct data. Here, our first animal is named Lon Bosco, and the species is of kind of infrastructure. He's a female and he's in this age. So we have here infrastructure as a female. We have André Schmidt from the species orchestration with the age of 24 and the gender of female. So we are reaching out to our API and we are getting everything we need, just as that. And also, if you are realizing it, our method or our action for showing the details of a specific animal is still working. We haven't changed the action yet. It's because of the construction of the action. See, we have the whole list. We are clicking here on one element. We are providing an animal. The animal we are providing is this one here. And then we go to our action and we are simply displaying the properties of this animal. Nice. So I will eat something now. I guess it's time to eat. I will think about our continuation. We have a lot of things in the roadmap. I haven't showed you how to delete animals, how to alter animals, or even how to bring new animals to your scheme. And also, there's a whole topic we need still to discover, the React router. So I will stop the video now and let's see again pretty very soon.